First and foremost, we give all praises to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahushai. Double honors to the elders that rule well, and salutation to the brothers that are pushing this word in truth and sincerity. You know, I am Roy, and to my right is
Ahmad,
and to my left is
Yaba.
Yaraba.
And today we're just going to a short little lesson on thanking the Most High always. You know, so first scripture will be Daniel chapter 2, verse 23.
This is Daniel.
Yeah. Chapter 2, right?
2 verse 23.
Yeah.
Yeah. Say, I thank thee and praise thee.
See, thank thee and praise thee. You know? Yeah, they always praise the Most High. Because that the man who actually wake up to the truth and actually bring it to this knowledge. And it's the same he can take it away from you. Yeah. See, yeah, they always give thanks and always praise him. And the same thing Daniel was doing.
O thou, Most High, of my fathers, who has given me wisdom and might, and has made known unto me, know what we desire of thee. For thou hast now made known unto us the king's matter.
Yeah, so basically it was Daniel giving thanks and praise to the Most High. And it's the same thing as in this truth, you always had to give thanks to the Most High, you know, as you wake up. Eating. You're doing something, that's how they give thanks to the Most High constantly, keep on giving them thanks and praise to them.
Damn.
You know? Because in an instant, he can take that spirit from you. You understand? So you have to pray and ask him not to do that.
This is Psalm 34, 1.
Yeah.
I will bless Yahweh at all times.
So you go bless the Most High at all times. He didn't say sometimes, he said all times. And that is the thing, some of us feel, you know, when you wake up in the morning, that is it. Everything good. As the brother say, you know, that you only thank him when things good. That any people in the world, that the only time that's good, the Most High thanks when they get something.
His prayer shall continually be in my mouth.
See, he praise
shall be continually in my mouth.
See, praise could be continually in his mouth too. When he talking, anything he doing, it continually there. When things bad, when things rough, he keep on praising the Most High right through. You know?
He can. Say, my soul shall make a boast in the hour.
See, his soul gonna make a boast in the hour. He go uplift no man. So he go boast to the Most High.
The humble shall hear thereof and be glad.
See, the humble and lowly then go hear. And they will be glad.
It's true, you know.
Yeah.
Oh, magnify Yahweh with me, and let us exalt his name together.
Mm-hmm. Say, magnify the Most High and exalt his name. Yahweh Bahashem Yahushai. No other name, no Jesus, no Allah. We magnify his name. Yahweh Bahashem Yahushai. That we say people straight outside here, daddy name. You understand?
Say together too.
Together, can.
Let our brotherly love continue, you know, that togetherness. Because as simple as you take a look at God to our brother, the Most High work through you. So when that brother praying for our way out, or pray for something, swallow money, or pray for something to eat, and you come along the way, and you was just there to help that brother, the Father work through you. Because when you help that brother to get us something to eat, the brother not thank, the brother telling you thanks, man, but he going to thank the Lord because then he was praying too for that help that way out.
Can.
The Most High walk through you, that brotherly love there.
Can.
Right? And he blessed you because how you do that. You bring praise to the Father. You make the Most High get glory and honor it.
Can.
But you just doing that good deed. You bring praise to the Most High because that brother can thank you, yes. You know, yeah, brother, but you come through in time. But the Most High use you and the same way now, that brother man glorify the Most High. Father, you hear me pray. You hear me cry. Yeah, son. So he gonna get the Most High thanks because of that one deed you do.
Can.
So bring glory to him. That brother love continue.
Can.
Right. So that exalting him together.
Happy Sunday. Mm-hmm. Yeah. 1 Thessalonians 5:18. In everything, give thanks.
Say in everything, give thanks. And that's what I was saying, you know. Not only the good times, you know. not only them good moments, okay, you know, in everything give thanks. Them bad times, because the Most High say you go chastise you if he love you, you know. See, I say still have to give thanks.
For this is the will of power in Hawashai Mashiach concerning you. This is the will of power, not your will. So even though you're going through everyday struggles, your will, his will still is to give him thanks.
Can't.
Because as we were saying from the video earlier, when they come into this truth, he redeem you. So you come like a prisoner to him. So you have no more will. You have no more will. It's the will of the Father, and one of his will is to give him thanks.
Can.
Yeah, go ahead.
Alright,
this is Romans 8, verse 28. Mm-hmm. And it says, and we know that all things work together for our good. To them that love Yahweh.
To who?
For them.
To them that love Yahweh.
No, that scripture is not for everybody. It's for them that love the Most High. And we don't know what is love. Yeah. If we don't know what is love and it's truth, then you don't have no right to be here.
To them that love Yahweh, to them who are called according to his purpose.
For them who are called, for them, not for everybody, for them who are called according to his purpose. So.
And this was just with Azzy, but I was explaining the love now. You know, this is the real love here. It's 1 John chapter 5, verse 3. He says, for this is the love of the Most High, that we keep his commandments. And his commandments are not grievous.
God.
Keep his commandments. Right? So even if you love the Most High, you will give him thanks.
God.
And joy and sorrow, same way.
Can.
Cannot difference. But everything that ordained, everything that predestinated is what you do, boy. And not give the man thanks, boy.
Can.
Somebody get Ephesians 5:20, put them in our place.
Happy September, yeah. We're
bring a thing up.
These are Psalm 40, you know, verse 4 and 5. Blessed is the man that maketh Yahweh his trust, right? And respecteth not the proud, nor such as turn aside to lies. Many, O Yahweh, my power, are thy wonderful works which thou hast done, and thy thoughts which are to usward. They cannot be reckoned up in order unto thee. If I will declare and speak of them, they are more than can be numbered. So, this alone here, showing that, you know, blessed is the man that make Yahweh his trust. Because his thoughts to us well are so much, you know. That's like how the scripture say, the wicked man know to give good gifts. Far less the Father, you know. And the Most High know so awesome, he deserves. He worthy of all this praise.
Can.
He worthy of every single praise and honor and glory. Because we're not here by guess. Let's know that is 144 and one third. And we wake up to hear this truth all over the world. We was fortunate to hear this truth. That is not by guess. You know? Thy love, thy real love. Count yourself blessed to get this love. And he love especially towards us. He arms over we. Because everything happened to me, you realize it was the point and shoot me for what was ahead. You know, thy real love and mercy.
Done.
Thy real love and mercy. So every day, as much as I could, I try to always magnify and glorify him. Because he would hear every single thing.
He
was around, we wake up around each other.
Thoughts always have to be like that now.
Continually. Try not to be on vain things.
Father, thank you for the water that you provide. Eating, thank you, boy, Father, boy, you know, for the food, because not many are fortunate, even though it's a spoon or a plate. Let's give them thanks now, boy, for keeping it thus far. Yes, sir. For keeping it hope for another. Plenty of brothers suffering all over the world, but you know what? That's part time. That's part time. Everything else that's lasting forever, that's part time.
That's part time. Everything can last forever.
This is Psalm 48. I delight to thy will, O my power. Yea, thy law is within my heart.
Say delight to thy will. Even in the prayer, say let thy will be done. You understand? So that will have to be done. You understand? Even in the prayer, there's a show. And I give it thanks. Is that the thing you have to let the Most High will be done?
Always.
And Ephesians 5:20.
Mm-hmm.
And somebody hold Psalms 105:8.
Ephesians 5:20. Giving thanks always.
It's a giving thanks always.
For all things unto the Most High and the Father in the name of our Lord Yahushua Mashiach.
In the name. Not, and he said all things, not some, he said all things.
Hebrews chapter 12 verse 6. He said, for whom the Most High loveth, he chasteneth and scourgeth every son who receiveth. So even as so the scripture says that who get chastised from the Most High because he loves you. So when you're going through that, you gotta give him as Ephesians say, you continually give praise even in that chastisement. You gotta give him thanks because he's showing that he loves you. You understand?
And I don't glory and honor to the Father himself now. He's still seeking him, he's still giving him praise despite what we're going through.
Can.
That'll show faith and trust also, because if you're in a bad situation, you understand, that's you actually have faith that he will help you through it. If a man never going through a hard time, he has no reason to have faith.
Can.
You understand?
I don't know. And if you're going through a good time, you don't have reason to call on the Father.
I appreciate for that here. This is 2 Timothy, I believe 4:2. He said, preach the word, be instant, in season, out of season, reprove, rebuke, exhort with all long suffering and doctrine.
You know,
so he say in season and out of season.
Can.
You know, whether good or bad.
Yeah, can.
That's like how you say married unto. When we so call out of the perform the marriages, all your system have it. They say you know sickness and in health, in good and in bad. Yeah, some palace we in season, out of season, always glorify that name. You understand? Make sure you always what you always had in your mind.
It's like that. And go back to taking, you know, take no rest. You know, as you say, let thy will be done. You can't be, you can't be in. You take an season like if you're in school.
Okay.
You understand? From January to June, you pumping, and the August holidays you taking.
That working on
you vacation. That kind of vacation that you say in season and out of season, that no rest time.
Rest time in this world.
I'll tell you.
I carry the Psalms. Psalms for me?
I have Psalms, yeah.
Well, before I bring a Psalm, bring Psalms 105 now.
105, was it?
Yeah.
You say this Psalm 105 verse 8. You say, he had remembered his covenant forever, the word which he commanded to 1,000 generations.
Right. So before you go on, yeah. Remember his covenant. So one of the covenants he was given thanks for is the Passover. I said, we're coming on to the end of the Passover. Like one of the covenants that we are trying to hold or rehearse. You understand? Our best of our ability. We had to get thanks still. But this might be the last Passover. So we know that's giving them thanks now, boy. For just bringing it to me how real it was. And we will always remember now, boy. And we will always remember what he did for us. So, you understand? So that we was giving them thanks, boy. He remembered the covenant, he remembered it. About
1,000 generations. And we've been taking for the longest while. For the whole Passover, men could walk around and see other people and then don't have no knowledge of the Passover even going on. So to be even part of the Passover is a big thing by itself. You understand? Hardly anybody actually had the knowledge of it to be able to keep it. And then there's the last one. Because people didn't have a chance to give time, so to take part in it, which was a real big thing.
Say Psalm 105 verse 10. He said, and confirm the same unto Jacob for a law, and to Israel for an everlasting covenant.
So Israel for an everlasting covenant. So as brother, yeah, but was saying just now, not many people are supporting it. Because Israel even know themselves. They even know themselves to give thanks to the Most High for the Passover. They even have that remembrance now, boy. But two-thirds have to be cut off. And that is his word. That is his will.
But there are more precepts? Yeah, there are Psalms 136. I read from 1 to 4. I say, oh, give thanks unto Yahweh, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever. Oh, give thanks unto Yahweh, power of powers, for his mercy endureth forever.
His mercy endureth forever. So even though that way, we live by faith, understand? So that way we will trust in the Most High for his mercies now, boy. Because we live in an Esau world right now.
Can.
Everything is, everything polluted, everything GMO, everything defiled what we eaten. And some of you still get the Most High thanks and praise for his mercies and do it forever now, boy.
Can.
Continue on.
Let's say, oh, give thanks unto Lord, Lord of Lords, his mercies enjoyed forever. To him who alone doeth great wonders, for his mercy enjoyed forever. See, him alone doeth great wonders, eh?
Yeah.
Nobody else.
See, that and I think, you know, and I mercy to forgive you. Tremendous wicked kingdom, it have way, but us can keep the Sabbath as good as they can. Because at the work, if they work, they lose a job. You understand? They lose a job, they, you know, it would be a hard time and no money in this kingdom. And to your things getting right now is basically the littlest bit of scrums they have money, that is a big help. So even that little bit of scrum, you have to thank the Father for your mercy. You understand? For that mercy given to you then. It's 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 3. You say, I thank the Most High, whom I serve from my forefathers with pure conscience. He said that without ceasing I have remembrance of thee in my prayers night and day. So it's without ceasing, you know, without stopping.
God,
he always remember the Most High night and day. No stop. You know that you know every day. You know, I sit on sometimes, this thing just pop into your head. The Most High just come into your head, strip, that's how the roll. You ain't stopping, you need Most High thanks. You always there every hour, every minute. You know, as you watch something and it, you know, like when you're working and stuff and you see things. One time the Most High come on you. One time that spirit it here. And you see without ceasing, without stopping. If you go through a day without thinking any Most High, you're not in your spirit. You're not in your spirit.
There you go. Even at times, you go, even be doing something and tell yourself, hey, I already wanted this, I already wanted that. And it ain't happening for you, and you're real fighting, and you might be vexed about it. And 2 weeks go past, and you realize, hey, if I didn't get that, boy, that mess me up. Yes.
Can.
You understand? He looking out for you, and you ain't even looking out for yourself.
Can.
You understand? That is Moses.
Let's as brother say, you know, constant now. Yeah. If a day pass and you think about the Most High, you know, then I spread something wrong with you, because that a day that's passed, if you don't be thinking about we.
Can.
Same way.
Can.
Right? These are Jeremiah 7:25. It says, since the day that your fathers came forth out of the land of Egypt unto this day, I have even sent unto you all my servants of prophets, daily rising up early and sending them.
Can.
You understand? Every day, rising up early and saying, how we hear the truth? How we really hear the truth from that time then till now? You know? Every day, rising up, thy love, that is favor. So for me, really not only to not think of the Most High, a day or hour or thy wickedness.
Can.
I will make me not grateful, we really not grateful. So even if you're studying, all the best to keep our law or something concerning me, Father. Yeah, but let that be continually on you. You understand? According to Psalm 1:1. How Psalm 1 say? You understand?
Yeah, we did. Psalm 1:1.
Yeah,
there's Psalm 1 to 2. He said, there's Psalms chapter 1, verse 1. He said, blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. He said, but his delight is in the law of Yahweh, and in his law doth he meditate day and night.
You hear that? He desire here is in the law of the Most High. In the law. You understand? That's what that man fighting. You're trying your best not to do evil, not to walk out the evil. That trying to be, that please, that trying to please the Father by doing this simple thing. By trying not to be wicked, by trying to by learning the law and going through it. They trying to walk according to the Father. You understand? So you know, day and night now, but that we say here. Yeah, and some of us delight is in the law of the Lord. And in his law that we meditate day and night. So himself you're lying down, try as much as you know, let your mind always be in that continually. Some people might think as easy to depend on whether living and how things go with them.
Can.
But you know, the Father knows. And once you try, you will make that way. You always make that way. So you know, give thanks and praise unto him. Yahweh Hashem and Shai.
It's Joshua chapter 1 verse 8. He said, this book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night.
That book of the law shall not meditate. Oh, this book, how we gonna know all this? This not gonna open to me just and read for itself. Yeah, understand? This is on a telegram here. we have to go through this. We have to go through the law. What the law is? Yeah, understand? This is what it is. How you want to rehearse? How you want to rehearse something that you don't know about, that you don't try to read up? You have to make an effort to go through this. This is love. This is love towards you. Right?
He said, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein.
You understand?
For
yeah.
Then,
go ahead, man.
He said, for then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success.
You hear that? Then you can make way prosperous. Then you will have good success by falling and taking heed to this word. You understand? By taking heed to this word, that's what we're
doing. For the ones who listen and don't understand, they mean success as in a big house, eh?
Yeah, can,
or
can,
a nice
can,
car, eh?
Can.
The physical. Because you say, we don't let treasures with moth and rust that corrupt.
Can.
Thy hair, thy physical, thy car, thy house, you know? In that time to come, this, you will be glad you this. That way you say, you're going to really be sweeping the mountain. You better just look at that. You see that them physical thing all day? Nah. When you know, hey, this is what you have to do. You're going to be better to them. But then sweet, you're going to be moving. This is bread, you see. Now by what? Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every bread that proceeds out of the mouth. This is the bread here. This is it here. You understand? These are part of the bread. These are the part of the bread. These are part of the bread here. You understand? So that's a good thing. Let's come to joy, boy.
John 10:15 and 16.
This John chapter 10
verse 15 is one of the most important reasons why must have the man comes.
He said, as the Father knoweth me, even so know I the Father, and I lay down my life for the sheep.
What he do?
And I laid down my life for the sheep.
Malcolm and laid down his life for the sheep, boy. Before you go and give him thanks to them. You go and end, stop end. You go and end giving him thanks to them.
Can't stop give thanks.
Can't stop give thanks, but what he did.
And mind you, me, when they give him thanks, it's by your words, but by your actions also.
Yes,
which is very important.
Now, and that is thing. It's not by this way you say it, you have to do too. That you say, I'm doing it, well, be a tour also. Yeah. You understand?
What scripture for?
Yes.
So Samuel 15 verse 23, you say, for rebellion is as sin as the sin of witchcraft.
Yeah.
And stubbornness is as iniquity and idolatry.
It's stubbornness, and that stubbornness is not to give thanks. And that stubbornness, it could even be that you're not even doing the Mosai, you're not even following the Mosai commandments. You're stubborn towards the word. You understand? You're stubborn towards it. I know the law states about a witch. You gotta die.
Some examples. And these are 1 Peter 2. 21. For even unto where we are called, because Mashiach, Yahweh Shai Mashiach, also suffered for us, leaving us an example that we should follow his steps.
Okay.
So when Yahweh Shai was here, he never ceased to stop giving Mosai thanks now. And I wanted the example what he did for us.
These are John 15:13. He said, "He's our love." Right? Who wrote the 12? "This is my commandment, that ye love one another as I have loved you," right? He said, "Greater love had no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends." Right? "Ye are my friends, if ye do whatsoever I command you." You understand? So that he said, "Greater love, right, had no man than this number, that a man lay down his life in friend." So when you really say man lay down your life, you enter your put yourself, you bring it as you fasted too, you bring your body under subjection about to let the spirit man grow. And when you could do something for a friend or brother, right, in the sense of, I want you to say, burn in your belly. You know what? Boy, this could make my brother, I'm going to try to stop blind this way. But you know it already affect you, but you're going to be 30. He really needed
sacrifice.
The sacrifice, strength, you sacrifice that for your brother. Because brothers all over the world sacrificing for we.
Yeah.
Simple as the elders turn up videos to edify us. Right? Them becoming a risk. And to all, the world seeing them, knowing them. You know? Them sacrificing for we. So same way, let me sacrifice for them, for everybody else. For the brothers towards the father world to do as well.
Yeah, that is
it. Same sacrifice.
Do what he commanded it to do.
Exactly, he commanded.
And that is and really a friend. Your friend is really them who doing what the father will. You understand?
Exactly.
That is a friend. Not these people outside here who the world party in alignment. That's not your friend. You understand? Because scriptures tell it state. It's a try somebody in order to be a friend. And how are you gonna try them through this?
Damn.
You ain't gonna try them carnally. You understand? You're gonna try them through this. And the people that do the father well, that's them who is a friend. You understand?
A righteous man can't be friend of an unrighteous man.
Can. See, it's Luke chapter 10, verse 21. He said, "In that hour, Yahweh Shai rejoiced in spirit and said, I thank thee, O Father, Lord of heaven and earth, that thou hast hid these things from the wise and prudent, and hast revealed them unto babes. Even so, Father, for so it seemed good in thy sight." So you know, even Yahweh Shai give thanks to the Father.
Always.
Always. You know? So any brothers,
let's continue to push in, continue all the brothers around the world, even in our camp, personally, continue pushing all the hardest, boy. Always give the man thanks, boy. Let that man always be on their mind.
Can't.
You know? Yeah. My first thing, wanting father's will. First thing, father's will, father's will.
Yeah. Try to be mindful also. You say be diligent, but that diligent is serious, that's in another man's work. And this is the father work, so let me know if you play like it is, you know? That's sometimes you know that brothers who take the heat work serious. And if you can take that so serious, you get to do it on time and let me this far less.
Can.
You know, we just fall short.
Yeah.
But yeah, well, as much as light, I mean, you can't take the heat work serious and not the father work more serious.
Can.
It shouldn't be so.
Can.
You know? What you won't even do for the heathen, far less for the father work, go you play. You understand? Because you won't have, you won't all out for the heathen work. But you can really perfect on nothing. Yeah. When that time comes, so push hard as much as for the father. He deserves that.
Can.
Let your body become a living sacrifice unto him. You understand? Do it with your all, as much as light on you. So keep fighting the good fight.
Can.
You know what I'm saying, brothers? Fight the good fight. So let's be strong and hold on and endure. And you know, Lakawa, heart to our Lakawa. You know? Tawara, man.
And as you see that his commandments are not previous. You understand? They go a certain time things will be hard for you. They go a certain things you know you like in the world that might bother you sometimes. but learn to put aside, because half the little things we just like, it's not worth it compared to offending the father and having to put you more trouble afterwards. It don't make sense, you understand?
You
reward greater than the little things you had to give up
now
sometimes.
You say the stuff you're going through in this present time is not worthy for the glory that you will receive to come.
Like you said, even Moses chose to suffer affliction in the children of Israel and to enjoy the season,
the seasons. Yeah,
and sit for a while to enjoy the wilderness, that for a while,
man,
that pleasure.
My faith, eh?
You understand? Moses cannot recognize that.
My faith, he just going for this. He's not even seeing. But he's not by faith now, but faith doesn't need it.
So again, you see, you know what presents the blue
side? Yeah, how are you? I'm
you see, to what I'm on.
Shalom. To the Arab video.
Shalom.
Shalom.
Good night.